this video, I'm going to show you how to install Disqus manually using the universal code. Before we begin, make sure you have the ability to edit your website's code directly. For this tutorial, we'll be using the Disqus blog. Right now, there aren't any comments, so let's add Disqus to the site. To get started, you'll need to first create a Disqus account and register your site at disqus.com. On the sign up page, create your account. Select I want to install Disqus on my site. Create your site and select a category. Next up, select the plan that's best for you. Finally, this brings us to the instructions for installing Disqus using the universal code. Let's take a look at that next. Here's the JavaScript code that we will be adding to our website. We find that most sites generally place Disqus at the end of the article page, so let's take a closer look. There are three parts to the embed code we wanted to highlight. First, the Disqus thread div. This is where the comment box is dynamically loaded onto the page, so make sure to include it above the embed script as shown here. Next, make sure you update the line containing embed.js with your site's short name. You can find your short name in the Disqus general settings. Lastly, configuration variables. These define how Disqus behaves on a page and are included within the Disqus config function. The two most important variables you will need to define are the page URL and identifier. What are they? Well, the URL variable is the canonical URL for the page and tells Disqus the location a discussion thread belongs to. The identifier is a unique value that Disqus uses for identifying the page and the discussion thread. We recommend using a unique ID that is unlikely to change in the future as the identifier. These two values can be dynamically generated server-side and will vary depending on your platform or CMS. Here are two examples of how you can configure these two variables in WordPress and HubSpot using functions and predefined variables specific to each CMS. Okay, so let's add our updated embed code onto our site now. On the Disqus blog, we use HubSpot as our CMS. Let's jump to the content settings where we can add the embed code directly to our template. We want to include it in the blog post footer HTML so that Disqus appears at the end of every post. Let's save those changes now and head back to our site. We're back now on the Disqus blog. Looks like everything is set up correctly. Go ahead and post a comment if you like. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and thanks for watching.